What up, world? What up, media? I am Drewize, and this is Drewize Topics. Thank you for clicking on this particular topic this evening. And thank you for viewing my previous videos here on YouTube called Drewize Topics. Thank you. I deeply, deeply appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. Now, this topic is true and it's a fact. And I dedicate this topic to the men, black men, and white men. I'm not going to talk about the Native American men because they, you know, they treat their women well. But I want to talk about men, you know, men. Because I can talk about Native American men all day long about how they treat their women, but I haven't ventured off and did research and study about the Native American way enough. I want to talk to the men. Men that have a wife, girlfriend. I want to talk directly to you as a man to have this type of thought pattern to do this and don't think nothing of it, you know? Because it's a true sense and a fact sense that the reason why these women are the way they are, negative, whores, hoes, harlots, you know, because of us. We are driving these women crazy. Because right now, it's a woman right now in the penitentiary, right now. They got kids and stuff, children and stuff, by a particular man. And this particular man, she went to jail because she done something, and right now her mind and heart, she feels sometimes, yeah, ain't gonna do that to me again, or do that to any other woman. Yeah, I did that. Walking around the penitentiary right now, boasting and bragging what she did to some man, and she knows she got children. After a while, she's sitting in that penitentiary. She think like, oh, I should never did that. I have children, you know? Now, topic is, men, you shall cherish your woman. You need to love your woman. You need to protect your woman. You need to honor your woman. For real. This is to the men. You know? Now, some of us, between the age of, I say, really, 24 through 30, 35, and 40. Now, I can excuse the fact because when you are 18, 19, 20, you don't know no better. You're still learning. You're still maturing. So, I ain't gonna talk about that. I'm gonna talk about when you get up in age like 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 35, 40. Now, when we get with a woman, and as a man, we surely see that she's worthy of faithfulness, love, of us, care of us, sometimes submit to us in a good way, not in a controlling way. Honor, counsel us when we are in trouble. Okay. We can have all that which is good in a woman, attributes they give to us, trustworthy, things like that. A good woman, we can have all that. But why is it that some of us men that have a woman, either a wife or a girlfriend, girlfriend about to become a wife, fiance, whatever, why is it that we have the thought pattern to have our eyes wander? Why do we want to cheat on our woman? Why do we want to abuse our woman mentally and physically? Why do we want to tear down our woman? You know? Why do we want to do negative things to her after she showed us that she's worthy of love to us and care to us, respect of us, and things like that positive to us? Why do we do that? You know? Why do you as a man, when you have a wife or a girlfriend, girlfriend about to be a wife, why do you want to talk to another woman? Why do you want to talk to a woman next door, woman across the street, streets over, down the street, the north side, south side, west side, east side? Why do you want to do it? You know? Now ask yourself this, man. You say you can never change a hoe. That's a lie, you know? Because that same hoe that you get with and you think negative of that particular woman that you claim that she's a hoe, and you say there's no changing a hoe. You can't change a hoe into a housewife. Let me tell you something. If that hoe sees you as a man that is right, you know, and she's willing to turn around and renew herself and change, you know, regardless of her reputation around the neighborhood, like Strawberry or something, regardless, you know, and you say, can't change a hoe into a housewife. Yeah, you know what? If she see you as a man that is doing what's right to her, respect her, honor her, care for her, love her, show her something different that these other BS bastards of a man was doing previously while she was dealing with them, and you show her something opposite, she would have no choice but to change. You know? Especially a man that believes in God. You know? You bring her to the church or something. You know? You bring her to the mosque or something. You know, so you bring her wherever you, a place of an organization where God's name is remembered. You know, that's what church and mosque, kingdom hall, whatever these places is, or worship. That is the place that God's name is mentioned. Remember, whatever. It's true as a fact. You can change a hoe into a wife. You know what I'm saying? You can. Because women, by nature, are not hoes, whores, sluts, bitches, harlots. No, that's not in a woman to do. But what came down to that point in circumstances, because dealing with a no-good man, that's why that woman turned out to be that way, nasty and filthy, because of a no-good man. You know? You know? So, I asked a question in a topic I did on this channel. Cheat, is it worth to cheat? I did a topic and a question about it. Is it worth to cheat as a man? You know, is it worth it? No, it's not worth it, because you're going to get some out of that man that you do not want. Now, you may have a wife, right? You don't love the side mistress woman. You just deal with that on a sexual level. You know? You have a girlfriend. And you have another chick that you talk to on a sexual level. You know, you don't love that woman, but you love your girlfriend. You love your wife. You hate, you don't like this woman. You hate that we just go over there and use her or have sex with her. Whatever, things in that nature. But is it worth to do that, man? Because like I said before, you're going to get something out of that that you do not want. One thing is, you have a wife, right? You got children by your wife. Now, do you want to create more problems for yourself? Of a thought of lust and horniness and sex that only lasts for like 3 minutes or something like that, or a minute, however you last in the bed with a woman, you know? Is it worth to live a double life with another woman, knowing you got a current woman at home raising your children, she go to work, go to school, or whatever she doing, and she think that you are the only one she's dealing with? You know, is it worth it as a man? You, it's not worth it. It's not. It is not worth it, you know, because you're creating problems for yourself. You know, you're going to get a sexually transmitted disease that you definitely do not want, because some of these sexually transmitted diseases, you cannot clear it up, cure it. Some of these sexually transmitted diseases is life-threatening. You know, I can go on and make a topic about why women cheat. But that's not what I'm focused on right now. You know? But the thing that us men need to realize, rather than have our eyes wander and have the thought while our eyes wander and flirt and always be another woman's face, that is categorized as lust. You know what I'm saying? For real. Lust. Now, one of my friends, longtime friend of mine, we lost contact, and he came over my house one day, and we had a talk outside, you know, outside. His woman was in my apartment watching TV. We just stepped out, have a talk, and we were just talking, and he told me that I don't believe that a man should be just settled with just one woman. I looked at him like, really? He said, I don't think a man supposed to be settled with one woman. I don't think God made us to be settled with just one woman. I said, you know, the devil is a lie. Satan lied to you, you know? When you have a thought to think that way as a man, you know, basically your thought pattern is like a dog. Dogs do this. When a male dog smells a female that's in heat, what do? He hop on that dog, make puppies with that dog, smell another dog that's in heat, he hop on that dog, and hop on that dog, and go all around the world, you know, having babies, puppies, litters, and don't think twice about it, you know? As a man, the scripture says, once a child grows up and leave his father and mother's house, he go out and search for him a wife. Not wives, a wife. So he can start his own structure or foundation of family. You know, I believe that once a man is mature enough to deal with a woman on a relationship level, significant other, soon to be his wife, whatever, I believe you're supposed to stick it out with just one woman, one man. You know, that's how it's supposed to go. You know, but see, the world that we are living in, society, you know, you think it look good to having one woman over here and one woman over here around your arm. You think that look good, you know, to be a player, to be a pimp, that do not look good, you know, that don't. It do not. And when you get in a relationship with a woman, You're supposed to honor the relationship. You know, honor. You don't cross that boundary. You don't cross that line of cheating or talking sexually or whatever time talking to a woman. Only when you're supposed to talk to another woman if it got something to do with business, making money. That's it. But not dealing with pleasure, you know. You're supposed to stick it out with each other, you know. When you step into a relationship and you want a woman, a significant other, a companion, you're supposed to honor. You're supposed to stick together until one of you croak over in the ground somewhere. You know, all that cheating you do, you know, all that cheating you do, messing around, you cause problems for yourself. You know, you cause headaches from yourself. You know, you cause stress and heartache and aggravation for yourself. You know, when you get to the age of 30, 35, 40, you know, you're supposed to have a wake-up call. You're supposed to be like, I want to be settled with just one woman only, and that is that, one woman, not the woman next door, like I said, not the woman across the street, like I said, not the woman down the street, not the woman on the north side, not the woman on the west side, not the woman on the east side, not the woman on the south side. You're supposed to stick it out with just one woman, but see, this is our problem as men. We want to put on a show, a boost of ego, a boost of think we look so good having all these women in our phone and all these women we talk to and stuff that do not look good. But see, when we have sons, like I said in the last topic, when we have children like sons, and we as the father wants to be a rolling stone and wants to mess around with all these women, you know, what through that shows that boy will grow up to realize like, oh, sometimes, that boy grows up and be like, oh, my father did it, he messed around a bunch of women, so I think it's alright for me to do, that's not alright to do, you know what I'm saying, that's a bad example, you know what I'm saying, a bad example, you know, in some cases, some children, some child, some son will say, I'm gonna be better than my father. I'm going to be better because how I'm going to grow up when I find me a woman, when I'm mature enough to handle a relationship, I'm going to be better than my father. I'm not going to be a cheater. I'm not going to be a whore of a man. If that's what you are, when you mess around with all these women and stuff like that, you are categorized as a harlot. You're categorized as a whore of a man. Flat out. And you're a hoe, you know? So, that's my thing. But you may call me I'm being this and that, lame, whatever. Call me what you want. But you gotta check yourself out in the mirror sometimes and say, look at yourself and say, I don't like this what I'm becoming. Because when you as a man wants to have 3, 4, 5 different women you're dealing with, and you got one woman at the house that she down for you, she loves you, she's faithful to you, she honors you, she respects you, and stuff like that. She loves you, she cares about you. That woman, and you want to mess around with all these other women, you know what I'm saying? You're categorized as a whore of a man. Trust me, you know? And like I said before, the reason why these women are the way they are, negative, you know? Because of us. Men, you know, the reason why the black woman is the way she is, because of us men, you know what I'm saying? Come on, us black dudes, you know? So, that's what I'm saying. All them foolish games that we do want to play around and stuff, we need to stop it. We need to quit it. We need to cool it out, you know? But see, I look at it like this. I have a woman, and she's 2 years younger than me. Now, I told her, and I looked in her eyes, and because she told me about her past, what type of bastard man she used to deal with, And sometimes she get a little untrust in me. And things of that nature. I keep telling her and looking her eyes and say, I'm not like that. I don't believe in cheating. Because cheating is wrong. Because when you cheat, you hurt the other person. And sometimes when you hurt the other person, that's dangerous for me as a man. You know? When I say I love you, I love you. And I said this to her, you know? And I've been honest. I told her straight up, you know, before we start talking back to each other again, reunited again, I told her that if you cannot honor the relationship, do not bring yourself into one. If you still want to mess around with all these bunch of people, you know, don't even think about getting into a relationship with somebody. Don't. Because you tarnish and you spat on and you stomp on the name of relationship. The name of love. You know? Don't bring yourself into one. You know? So, when I demonstrate something different from these bastards of men previously that you used to deal with, it's totally new to her. You know? Because I've been honest. I've been real. I've been genuine. You know? Come on. Any man can say he loves you. You know what I'm saying? But action speaks louder than words. Come on. You can say to that woman, baby, I love you. The moment she wake up, baby, I love you. The moment she close her eyes. Talk is cheap. Your actions prove it. You know what I'm saying? Come on. It's some dudes right now. Got a woman. Still talk to other females on social media. That ain't right. That's wrong. You know what I'm saying? That's not right. And I kid you not, men. When you hurt a woman like that, because it does hurt, ain't no woman going to brush it off her shoulders. If she brush off her shoulders so easy that she know you cheating, she didn't care nothing about you in the first place. You know? But if she shows signs that she's hurting because of that, because of your cheating, whatever, and she get hurt, and she wind up trying to launch at you, trying to hit you, or cuss you out, keep on doing that. Some women get to that point and say, I don't give a damn no more. I'm going to take you out. And some women get off. Get off. You know, they kill a man, you know, that man was sleeping around. They kill their men that was sleeping around, and they kill them, and they get off. Stand in front of the judge. You know, she can say this and that in self-defense or whatever, knowing that he wasn't sometimes. Stand in front of the judge, look at the judge in the eyes with an innocent face, sad, remorse face. Judge say, okay, you serve 5 years, and you get out and 2 years with good behavior. You know? Yeah. It's not good to cheat. It's not good to cheat, man. It's not good to cheat. It's not good to be a flirt. It's not good to do that. It's not good for you as a man to talk to other women on that level when on that level you got somebody else. The main chick you dealing with. You know? The one that holds you down. The one that loves you. Cares for you. Sometimes submit to you. Honor you. Give her all to you. The one woman that says to another man that another man tries to approach her on that level. Trying to holler at her. And she gives him that cold shoulder, leave him in the dark and say, get out my face. You ain't worthy. Get out of here. I rebuke you. Depart from me right now. Those type of women. But it seems like those type of women that treat a man so right those type of women get treated so wrong by a man. And that's why women become whores, harlots, bitches, sluts, and things of that nature because of that reason. Think about it. I'm at the age of 29 years old. You know, 29. And I don't do the things I used to do. True enough, I admit, when I was in a relationship with my ex, I cheated. You know, one time. I cheated. I told her about it. I straight up and told her. Because I couldn't live that life no more. I had remorse. I said, I had enough of this. I had enough. I'm going to spill the beans. See, when you spill the beans as a man and tell the truth, then come out and tell the truth that you've been cheating, you've been messing around while you've been dealing with your woman. If you tell the truth, this is how it's going to go down. True enough, she's going to get upset with you. She might break up with you. She will respect you, you know, because you told the truth. Now, she may stay with you and still say, I don't trust you. What you doing? And having thoughts in her head like you messing with somebody else. You know, she may be upset with you while she's still dealing with you. But at the same time, you told her the truth and she still be hurt about it. But she have to say, I respect you for telling me the truth. I'm upset with you. I'm hurt about it. But thank you for telling me. It's up to her to be with you or not. But some of us men are so cowardly and so weak. You know, when we mess up, treat that woman so wrong. Oh, now you want to turn around and do what's right. Because you see, she picked herself up, find herself, like the prodigal son, find herself, you know, and say, forget you. I'm out on you. Hell with you. And move on. Now your sucker self, you know what I'm saying, punk self, want to come around and say, baby, please take me back. Baby, please take, get yourself on somewhere. You know what I'm saying? Begging a woman to come back to you after you treated her so wrong, they don't work that way in this life today. You know what I'm saying? Like that song says, TGT, the R&B group, Tank, Genuine, and Tyrese. What that song says on that album, Three Kings, what it say? Next time I come around. You know, the song is basically talking about how these men, one of the men, the song was basically sung about, the title of it and the name of it is about they mistreated a woman by cheating. You know, I'll be ready next time I come around. That means when the next relationship I get into with a woman, I'll treat her right. You know, I love her. I'll forsake other women. My eyes will not be drawn to other women. You know, next time when I get in another relationship, I'm going to start all over and treat this woman, the new current woman, right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Think about that, man. When are we going to grow up to be men? Because right now, these women, especially the black women, you know, they need a real black man. A real black man. To sweep them off their feet like Superman. You know? Come on. There are some out there that are those type of men that do right for their women. But there are some type of men that do not do what's right for their women. And the ones that do not do what's right for their women are considered dogs. You know what I'm saying? Dogs. Life of an animal. You want to hop on one dog, get that dog pregnant, make litter by it, hop on the next one, don't think nothing of it. You're a dog. You know what I'm saying? A dog. And that is that. Drewize. And this is Drewize Topics. Post a comment about what I just said if you'd like to, because this is truth. This is truth to the highest, most truth. Like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. I am Drewize. The Drewize. The one and only. Drewize. Drewize. Peace.